Alright, yeah. So, in the respect of this evening, it's been kind of a, I guess, a hay show for the Trump man. So it appears he will be the president of America. Now, I'm here in my little Saturday tonight, and I'm like, well, interesting that when we go into the politics of fashion, the actual clothing themselves, it really doesn't take that much extra, you know. It's not a financial plunder to be wearing a sheet everywhere. But that is often construed as a liberal thinker, a liberal philosopher. And then you have to, yeah, so now we're looking at the three-piece suits, we're looking at that type of push. It's so constricted, isn't it? It's so constrained, that so tight. You know, I have this even tight tonight, but it's a tight everything, belts, waistbands, cummerbunds, everything tight. Yeah. So maybe that's what he's representing here for this new world, is the tight clothing, and everybody will be all constricted like yuck. And even tonight I'm like wrapped my sari too tight up here, and I'm not happy with it. And then before I put it into some other stupid haute mode show. And it's not supposed to be like that, but it just felt like it. But yeah, we're not supposed to have this constriction of clothing, and then have an entire wardrobe in constriction of clothing. So it's almost like that's what that agenda is speaking. You know. So how do we break out of that? You know, when it's in this. It feels like a forced epilogue back, you know. I hate to say it, but what is with the stigmata of the past being reborn? Why do I feel that sometimes with his, say, statements? Why do I feel like this is a new, what do we call that, when they put the Christ dude on the cross? A new, like, what? They had a special name when they did that. Come on. But yeah, when they put him on the cross, that was a special thing they used to do for the dudes, the people that put him up there. It's almost like resurrecting back that far, you know. Everybody running around saying, hey, I'm Christian. Okay, how Christian are you? You know, we're starting to get the nails out, you know, it all starts to get really heavy. And yet I'm not wanting to diss the guy. I don't want to diss the guy. I don't want to diss the situation. Because I think, all in all the dissing, all of that, you are so different, and I attack your difference. I attack your difference again and again and again. It's just created a wall and another wall. And so the two walls end up fighting each other. Clash. Different wall to a different wall, and they fight. So when we have such an extreme wall, and then you have another extreme wall, and they're not looking at anything the same. You know, what are the sames? What are the sames? Is there anything the same? Do you have any agreements? And in a way, okay, fine, you have extremes on you or in you or spoken in you, and the other has extremes. Can we make those extremes not even be heard? Why would those extremes get to be put on the table? Why would extremism be put on the table? Why don't we put the sames on the table? We feel this way, same. We feel this way, same. That is an agreement. You put that on the table, you all have a meal together, and you don't choke, you don't get indigestion, you don't die right there while you're eating. You have a wonderful meal together because you're having the same agreements. Now, when you put extreme on the table, extreme, it's just, you're hurting everybody. Hurting everybody. And then, but my extreme has to win. My extreme has to win, you know. So that's what it's all about, you know. The extreme has to win over the sames. How sad. How very sad. Because when you think about it, I don't care who you are. I hear about you. I have to live with you in my head. You understand? I have to live with you in my head. Your opinions. You brought those on me. Your extremes. So we, in essence, we are all living together. I'm living with this Trump fellow. I'm living with this Clinton woman. We're all living together. They're in our heads. Their opinions. So when we come to meditation, when we're dealing with meditation speak, well, if I have Hillary Clinton in my head and I have a Donald Trump there in my mind's eye, I don't want them to meet in extremes. I only want them to meet in the sames. So when we have discussion, when you have a discussion in your head, even in your dreams, let's have discussion in our head that is a discussion of the people in agreement, the people in doesn't have to be a love fanatica. They don't have to adore each other. We don't have to adore the Republican Party, blah, blah, blah. Or the liberals, you know, or vice versa. However, in our head, can we just make those? Can we just make, hey, make peace there? So if we can make peace in our heads, each and every one, that person is going to generate peace. He's going to bring in good over his extremes. If we can all change our thoughts, each and every one of you, that he is going to be that man, no matter how Republican you thought he is, die hard or whatever, to bring war, if we can all push that, each one of us, that's momentum. That's what meditation is. That it is a whoosh, it is a swoosh, and the man will be. What? Maybe. Maybe we can. We can magic through, you know what I mean? Magic through and create some kind of actual event that changes his possible chaos. Because it is. A man who lives in extreme and walks in extreme and is able to be in extreme is a chaos. A man who lives with a destiny of agreement and the same is not a chaos. You understand? So we need to control his righteous wants. So if we have to become head controllers, each and every one of us, no, you're never going to do that. You're going to be a beautiful man. And you are even going to go and shake Hillary's hand and say she and you were great, worthy opponents. And you're going to take on board some of her things. These are all in your mind, all to digest in your own mind, to bring to your own table, each person in meditations. Throughout their day, as you're going walking your car, it's going to be better. He is going to change. He's young now. He will change. And it will be a beautiful political journey. Okay? So then we can breathe. Then we can breathe, but we have to really believe it. We have to believe it. We cannot be just, it's not gonna happen, it's not gonna happen, I'm scared. We have to believe that there won't be buttons pushed and nuclears here or there. Alright? We have to really believe that he's gonna be a good man, and he's gonna find sames, and he's gonna find agreements, and he's not gonna walk on extreme hot coals and sit on them. You know what I'm saying? He's not gonna be a masochistic extreme to hurt us all. He's gonna be a good man. I know that seems far-fetched because of the hype. It seems far-fetched. I don't know. People can change, you know. It's just that choice. Each day you wake, you know, to change. Each day you wake. Throw away your old ugly past and change to the next day. It's very simple. Very simple. Alright. I know. Before everybody says, oh, it's the money plunderer, it's just going to follow the money trail like it's a money nose thing like this. The money is all on the Democratic side. The money is on the Republican side. The money is all over the place. I don't think it's the money. No. No. So same, and you already see the same already, all of those red states in the middle. You already saw that same. And you already saw the same that he's a man as president and not a woman. So yeah. The Democrats did wrong. They should have been the Republican woman and the Democrat male this time around, but anyway, it's too late. It's too late that he's there now, so yeah, we'd have to try to make peace and believe that he can think past himself and think past extremes and think about it, you know, stop having overtight knots on his sari, because oh my gosh, it's just awful. Try to wrap a sari up, and if you over tighten it, you can feel that. You can feel that energy is just wrong. It was not supposed to be that way. Alright. Alright, ciao.